We have finally reached the 10k mark and we have no one else to thank but you. Thank you so much for always walking side by side with us and for always supporting us. Now before we get into today's topic, we have an announcement. We are finally on Instagram, so do give us a follow at Halabella01. And we are so excited to let you know that we are also releasing our merch, so do remember to check them out. And that is not it. We just keep having news for you. We have a second and third channel. If you love fiction, you can check out our videos on Halabella 2. And if you love to hear facts on our human body or like to research on the number of calorie intake, then we would love to see you on our channel named Sell It. All the links will be provided in the description, so see you guys there. Okay, let us get back to our topic for the day. Kents Cavern is one of the United Kingdom's most important archaeological sites. This cavern has been excavated numerous times since the 1820s by some of the United Kingdom's most famous archaeologists. In 1927, a group of excavators unearthed the most exciting find ever found in Kents Cavern. A jaw fragment and three teeth were discovered and are now known to be the oldest find of a modern human in Northwest Europe. This mandible was given the name KC4 jaw. Over the years, researchers have debated whether the fossil was that of a modern human or a Neanderthal, as well as how old it was. It was not until 1989 that radiometric dating was applied to the KC4 jaw fragment, providing an age of 30,900 years. A few other funnel bones, including one of a woolly rhino, provided an age of 37,000 years. But the funnel bones were found about a meter higher up in the stratigraphic sequence. More work was needed to be done to clarify why the older funnel remains were found above the KC4 maxilla. Scientists still argue on the age of the fossil, but what they all agree on is that one bad date can rewrite the entire prehistory of our species in Europe. In the same year of 1989, scientists at the Oxford Radiocarbon Accelerator Unit attempted to directly date the bone and came up with an age of approximately 35,000 years. This date for the jawbone was consistent with then-current views that modern humans had entered Europe about 40,000 years ago and then spread from east to west. In 2011, an interpolation model was applied to the radiometric dates provided by the fauna and concluded that the maxilla may date to between 44,200 and 41,500 years of age. These results caused heated debate, with critics arguing that the Kents Cavern team were too trusting of the interpreted site formation processes. Dr. Tom Higham of the Oxford Radiocarbon Accelerator Unit said that the relative redating of this specimen puts it at the very dawn of the arrival of modern humans in Europe. So early, in fact, that it makes us wonder if it is from a modern human or from a Neanderthal. In either case, the specimen will occupy an important place in the European prehistoric record. If the jawbone is Neanderthal, it would be the first classic Neanderthal confirmed in mainland Britain. Professor Stringer of the National History Museum added that people have been arguing that modern humans may have been in Eastern Europe early, but they certainly weren't in Western Europe. So if the mandible found at Kents Cavern does turn out to be a modern human, it would mean some of them at least had come across very early. What's more, such an overlap could make it more likely that Neanderthals who made sophisticated ornaments and tools in their last years copied these techniques from modern humans rather than inventing them on their own. While caves remain difficult archaeological sites to excavate, revealing complicated stratigraphies, it is important not to entirely dismiss the work done at Kents Cavern or any other archaeological site. Some caution is necessary, But Kents Cavern has provided the paleoanthropological community with the possibility that Homo sapiens were roaming the British coastline as early as 42,000 years ago. In the meantime, the exact age of the fossil and who it belonged to might remain a mystery. And with that, we have come to the end of the video. What are your thoughts on this, guys? Let me know in the comments section down below. Thanks for watching, and please continue to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.